Hello students, today we are going to see chapter number 3 of standard 12 commerce subject account. Today again we are going to see the asset side of the balance sheet, where we are going to bifurcate the asset side into the main head as well as sub head. Let's see illustration number 9. Following balances are extracted from books of Gujarat Limited as on 31st 3 7 day. Prepare statement including asset of balance sheet as per schedule 3 of the Companies Act 2013. Okay, so here they are asking us to prepare the asset side of the balance sheet. So as we discussed before, very first we have to write main head and sub head of the balance sheet, and here then we have to write the balance of the account. So here, illustration number 9, balance sheet of Gujarat Limited as on 31st 3 7 days. So here, very first head of the asset side is non-current asset. In that, fixed asset is again divided into two categories, that is tangible asset as well as intangible asset. After that, the second heading is non-current investment. And the last one is other current asset. So these are the heads which are given in the schedule 3 of the Companies Act. Now let's see the balances which are given in the illustration number 9. So here interest accrued is given. So interest accrued is other current asset. So that will be written under the head other current asset. Interest accrued. So this is 3000. After interest accrued, the other asset is given to us is a plant and machinery. Plant and machinery, as we know, it is a fixed tangible asset. So that we will write under the head fixed tangible asset. Plant and machinery, and that is it. That is a 6 lakh. After plant and machinery, other asset is given to us is a cash on hand. As we know, cash on hand is a cash and cash equivalent. Then we are going to write under the head cash and cash equivalent, cash balance, cash on hand. And it is a 37,000. After cash on hand, the other asset is given to us is a trademark. As we know that trademark is an intangible asset, so here we will write trademark, and that will be 20,000. After trademark, other asset is given to us is a debtors. Debtors, as we know, that it will fall under the trade receivable. Trade receivable means debtors plus bill receivable. So debtors will be fall in the trade receivable, and the amount of debtors is a 42,000. And after debtors, another is a 10% Narmada bond. As we know that Narmada bond is a non-current investment. It is for the long period of time. So it will be fall under the non-current investment. 10% Narmada bond. And the amount of debt is a 17,000. After that, the other asset is a loose tool. So loose tool will be fall under the inventory. And the amount of loose tool is 18,000. Now, after that, another one is a telephone deposit. Telephone deposit is a long-term loan and advances that is given to the telephone department. So that will be telephone deposit, and the amount of that is 30,000. Now, after that, unit of mutual fund, and it is a temporary investment, so it will be fall under the current investment. So here, unit of mutual fund, and it is given that it is a temporary. So that is 10,000. So this is how we supposed to mention all the assets. Now let's make the total of this. So here, as we can see, that tangible, intangible asset, non-current asset, long-term loan and advances, but other non-current assets are not there. So total of this is 6,000, 20,000, 70,000, 30,000. So total will be 7,20,000. Now, here we can see that investment, inventory, trade receivable, cash and cash equivalent, but short term loan and advances is not there. The total of these will be 10,000, 18,000, 14,000, 42,000, 37,000, and 3,000. 110,000. So total of non-current and current asset will be 8,30,000. Here it is a total. So students, you may note down this in your notebook. Thank you for watching this video.